Right on the set.
Fred, you made a lot of changes this season, right? To try and really get after the gold.
Yep.
One of the things you've done is elevate JB, make sure he's got everything he needs to be a mechanic, right?
Yep.
And I think your secret weapon this season is Buzz.
Yeah, definitely. These two guys are my right-hand men. If I didn't have them, I wouldn't be here. JB keeps everything mechanically running, and I put a lot of pressure on that guy right there. I make sure Buzz knows that he is the one making some of these calls when I'm not there. If I go away, I know it's in good hands. That's the type of guy you need to really succeed out here because there's no resources. So having a guy like Buzz, I say he has redneck ingenuity. He can fix anything, with anything.
I go in to succeed. I'm not going in to fail. Right? I don't quit. That's what it's all about.
That fits with your motto.
Yeah, it sure does.
It does.
You know how I found Buzz? Yeah. We hired Buzz to build these cabins. He had a little lumber mill. As he was building these cabins, with JB's help, I was running the excavator for the first time up here trying to figure it out. And I look over and Buzz is just doing this, shaking his head. And I'm like, who is this guy? Build the cabin. And he gets in and he shows
me. Low power mode. And Buzz comes over there and is like, hey, turn that up, you know.
He just knows what to do.
Buzz, let's be honest. Let's pretend like these guys aren't here. What was your impression of these guys when you first saw them? And tell the truth.
Truth, 100%, these guys need help. Fred, you look at Fred, you know, maybe not everybody sees Fred the way I see Fred. Fred has got a great heart, right?
Yeah.
He's a great man.
Wow, it makes you emotional.
Thank you, Buzz.
I think the last thing I expected was to see Buzz cry. I think it's unique, Fred, right, that you find someone from the Yukon with so much experience in mining and being able to do everything that doesn't want to just look at you and point at you and laugh at you. They actually want to jump in and help.
Right?
Yeah. He's a teacher. You know, building that wash plant, we just went to Buzz, and we would be like, what's next?
You didn't just go to Buzz. You went to Buzz's backyard.
Yeah. Buzz's backyard.
I mean, let's be clear.
Treasure trove.
I don't have a whole lot of welding experience, so.
You'll learn as we go.
There reached a point where I was like, I need more. I need more knowledge. And I can't keep going to other people off the mine site to get it. I need someone on the mine site that knows this stuff, that can look at something that's broken and be like, you know what? We can use a garden hose to fix that, and it's fixed.
Well, what are we talking about for work? Because it looks like it needs everything.
We're going to fabricate a new skid, the new hopper underneath.
Okay.
Well, I went over and checked out this guy's backyard wash plant,
you saw the good stuff.
It's a thing of beauty.
Yep, sure is.
Check it out. So Buzz, my understanding is that you're in the running for kind of the MVP of the crew this year, that you've been huge for Fred. You built the plant.
Designed it. We all built it.
It's not the biggest of plants, right?
Nope. But not always as big or better, right?
Right. These things are super expensive. Like, if he were to buy, like, a brand new plant, he couldn't afford it, right?
Well, that's right.
That's all he could afford is to pull something sitting in your backyard out and kind of resurrect it, right?
Yeah. It's all scrap metal from the backyard.
All scrap metal from your backyard.
Yeah.
And did you design this thing specifically for this ground?
Yeah.
What are the modifications you made to handle this ground?
That bonus box.
I call that the bonus.
That's the biggest thing.
So is that catching bigger gold?
It catches about 85% of what?
In this green deck in the bottom, it's not even being caught in the sluices.
This bottom section of the sluice is useless.
Right.
It's just there.
It's there for safety. If you're catching gold here, you're in trouble.
That's right.
Yeah. Explain to me how it works.
This here is your first point, your first contact, right?
First contact with the gold.
That's right. Most plants just have a slide that goes down into that bottom.
Most plants, they're catching their gold right there, the top of the sluice.
Then it goes into the sluice. We designed this with this here. Your dirt gets dropped in, water hits it. Gold is 19 times heavier than water.
Yeah.
Right? So it's going to fall the fastest. That gold drops, it hammers into that mat. It's locked in. It does not move anywhere. This here is for like everything, because there's fine gold, coarse gold. We got little nuggets.
So you're not even catching gold in those riffles?
We catch it there, but not a whole lot.
So 85% here, 15% there.
It looks clean. Really well separated, too. Real clean.
Can we see in here? How do you clean this out?
It's got the same expanded metal that it does down here.
Oh, it's the exact same?
It's the exact same. It's just in a different location as well.
When's the last time you guys cleaned this out?
Last Friday.
4,000 yards ago.
Yeah. So there could be gold in there.
Oh, I'm hoping for 20 ounces or better on this cleanout.
This is cool. We're actually doing a cleanout. Can I see in here?
Come on, Buzz. Find me a picker.
Right here, Buzz. Come up here, right here. You see it right here?
Yeah, I see it right there, yeah.
Right up underneath this.
There's gold right here.
Yeah, right. Go a little bit farther.
Oh, there you go.
There you go. Gold.
That's wire gold.
Wire gold?
Yeah, that stuff you call that wire gold. That comes from close to the source, right?
We're rich. Now, you only need like what? Like 800 more of these for a 20 ounce cleanup, right?
Yeah.
8,000.
8,000 of them.
Yeah. Here you go.
You got a better one?
Really?
That's a good one.
Oh, there you
see, this is how you get gold. Yeah. This is how you catch gold fever, right? You see this and you're like, damn.
Almost big enough for an earring, then.
That's a pretty big one. This is a really, really impressive operation. I wish you guys nothing but the best. Hope you get more gold like this.
So I don't think I've ever seen that setup before, Fred, on Gold Rush, where you've got this, what do you even call that lower tray you've got there?
We call it the buzz box.
The buzz box.
It came from his head.
I've never seen that before on Gold Rush, and I've seen probably, 10 wash plants. Why did you design it that way?
To catch everything. The point of gold mining is to catch all the gold.
Yes,
right?
I would say that's...
If you're not catching all the gold, you're wasting your time.
Right.
So why catch a percentage of it when you can catch it all?
You have upgraded, right? Like, the mink is incredible. You got a nice plant. Now, what else do you need? Gold.
Whew, yeah, a lot of it.
So it seems like you're set up and you're in better position than you've ever been. You just got to find the right ground.
Well, the ground here is spotty, but really, if you think about it, we built that wash plant. We didn't have any engineering degrees. We didn't have any like blueprints to do it. So we're still making fine tuning adjustments on it. And mm-hmm. It's to the point now where it's running beautifully. I mean, we blew 3 motors this season on it because the motor was placed in the wrong spot and the torque was off and all kinds of other issues. But every single issue we've had, we've fixed. And to this point, if you would back me on this, I believe it's running 100%. So it took us a while to get it there, but it's there now. And that wash plant's gonna sit down there until it either gets blown up or we drag it to another claim.
I know everyone's working really hard, but these guys have made some huge contributions and have really set you guys up.
Yeah, every single person here works their ass off every single day. Their roles are just vital to this operation. And I know an operator is vital as well, but a mechanic, I learned that in Oregon. You can't mine without a mechanic. And having someone with a knowledge like Buzz is elevating us so much. I now know that you need someone like Buzz.
I think it was a wise move, Fred.
It definitely was.
No criticizing that move.
No. Thank you. Finally.